In this demonstration, we will use the Self-Check Worksheet for Study Data Preparation for a commercial IND application with non-clinical study data. This will help us determine if the files and information we are planning to submit are sufficient and meet study data standards. We'll start by selecting the FDA center to which we'll be submitting. So I'll select CDER, and the application type is commercial IND. And for the purposes of this example, our application number will be 123456, and our sequence number 0001. And I'll skip non-required information for this demo. In section 2, we'll enter specific information about the study. Our study ID is XYZ-123. This is the first time we're submitting information about the study. And for the title of our study, we'll just use repeat dose toxicity study. And repeat dose toxicity studies go in sections 4232. We'll put 4232 as our ECTD section. And that's in module 4. We're submitting non-clinical study information. And our study data type, we'll select tabulation. In section 3, we enter information about the study tagging file. So we confirm that yes, the files that we're submitting are in a study section, section 4232. And we do have a study tagging file prepared, and we plan to submit it. And we've double checked that all of the files that we're submitting are referenced in the STF for the study. Our study ID in the STF is XYZ-123, and we confirm that that's the study ID that we previously entered. Now, we don't plan to submit the XPT data sets with this study. So we'll select no for 3F, and 3G asks, if the study is non-clinical, are there study files with one of these three file tags? And so we'll select yes, because we do plan to submit study reports with our non-clinical study. Section 4 focuses on TS file requirements for trial summary data sets. Our study started July 1st, 2016, therefore prior to December 17th, 2017. We'll use a table to determine the TS file requirements. The study is non-clinical, submitted with the commercial IND application prior to December 17th, 2017 to CBER. So a simplified TS file is required. Just to note, CBER's non-clinical requirement for standardized data begins March 15, 2023. The self-check worksheet will be updated to incorporate CBER's requirements. So we confirm that a simplified TS file is required. But unfortunately, we were not prepared for that, and we have not included a TS file, which indicates that we would fail validation rule 1734 for a missing TS file, and therefore not providing a study start date for our study. So once we prepare a simplified TS file, we can continue to complete the self-check worksheet and ensure that the additional validation rules will pass.